I would like to begin by welcoming everybody on this rather difficult day with the rain and that to the 33rd annual Walk for Peace. 33 years, the people of Winnipeg have organized and conducted this walk in all sorts of weather. So I think we should all congratulate ourselves for continuing that tradition, for making it possible, because it's an important event in the life of Winnipeg and in the organizing of people in Winnipeg against the danger of war and for peace and real peace and security. And more recently, this is now the fourth annual Peace Festival, which is an adjunct to the Walk for Peace and is important in further developing that movement for peace and genuine security in the world, and involving Winnipeggers in that movement. So I'd like to say that, just by way of introduction, 33 years ago, what was foremost in people's minds at the first Walk for Peace and the subsequent ones for the following decade or so later was the danger of nuclear war between the two superpowers on the world stage at that time. And I'd have to say that while conditions have changed, it's very important that we continue this walk, because all the dangers that were present 33 years ago when the world got mobilized against the danger of nuclear war, all those dangers continue to this day and exist in what's the developments that are going on internationally around us. So very important that we carry on these walks for peace, these actions to mobilize the people of Winnipeg on the questions of war and peace and averting war and ensuring peace, but a genuine and lasting peace that is really based on the people's movement for a peace and people's respect for sovereignty of countries, the rights of people. Because while there's a movement for peace and governments talk, many governments in the world talk about peace and engaging in actions to defend peace, responsibility to protect human rights, those are really very hollow, as we can see, because in the early 1990s, you'll remember there was the first war against Iraq. Following that, there was the war in Yugoslavia, the NATO-led war in Yugoslavia, which Canada participated in. Canada also participated in the first war in Iraq. Then there was the second war of Iraq in 2003, followed very closely by wars in Libya, wars in Syria, and now, of course, we see what's happening in the Ukraine and the dangers there. And, of course, all these wars were undertaken around the concepts of either regime change, as in the case of Iraq, where it was said that a dictator like Saddam Hussein could not remain in power and that he had weapons that were dangerous to world peace and security, or on the responsibility to protect, such as was the danger that there would be war in Syria, major war and confrontation in Syria by the big powers. So while various governments talk about these things, the reality is very different, that these are often used as means to just extend the influence of the big powers in various regions in the world. And we saw that very clearly in Yugoslavia when that happened. We saw that again in Libya. We saw that as part of the maneuverings in Syria between the various powers. And we see that today in the question of the Ukraine. So our movement for peace is not the same as when you often hear these political leaders talk about peace or talk about their interests in peace. So again, that's what distinguishes our movement, our events, and our activities. And I want to say again, it's very important that for 33 years we've carried this on and that we've now looked at producing another element of that, which is a peace festival to draw people in around these questions after the Walk for Peace. So without any further remarks from you, I'd like to introduce Florence Uwalowe, if I've pronounced your name correctly or almost correctly. And Florence will introduce herself in terms of the organizations she's with. So Florence, just please come up.
Bring it a little down. Thank you. Okay. Good morning, everyone. My name is Florence Okwudili. My name is Florence. Is it okay? Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm originally from Nigeria and lived here since 2000. That is my 14th year in Winnipeg. I'm very, very happy to join this group. I've known this group since 3 years ago through the organization that I'm representing here today. Today I'm representing two organizations, okay. International Institute for Women's Rights and also Unemployed Youth Africa, which is an organization that champions the employment of Africans in Winnipeg. But today I'm marching for peace, and I'm bringing the issue of the missing Nigerian girls this morning to the knowledge of everyone. I just feel that 300 plus girls went missing in our modern times can actually lead a whole country into degenerating into war. And it's gradually going on, and our leaders are just busy doing their own thing. I feel that issues like this is something that people like you and I could champion and march for today. It's raining, but for those who care for peace, they will stand for peace in all times. Under any weather, we will come out. And I'm happy that we are all here today to tell the world that we are here for peace. And we pray that every other nation that is experiencing one way of unrest or the other, that this morning as the rain pours down, that the rain will also pour down good policies and good minds in their heart to understand that people want justice, people want peace above every other thing. The people want peace. And this morning we are here to say that we also want peace. We are praying, I'm hoping that our girls will be brought back as we keep them in our minds and prayers. And I'm hoping that every one of you, you take this back home and to your various organizations to also remember them in your prayers. Thank you.
Okay, with that, we are ready to begin the Walk for Peace. The theme for the Walk for Peace is, and this is the banner that will be at the front, is peace and prosperity, not war and austerity, which is the theme that the Canadian Peace Alliance has been working on for several years, in opposition to really what is going on, which is within Canada, everyone is being demanded that the social well-being in Canada is going to be subject to austerity and measures such as that. Yet Canada engages in various military adventures abroad, such as the of Libya, such as its role in the Ukraine, and so on. So the Canadian Peace Alliance, and where Peace Alliance Winnipeg is part of the Canadian Peace Alliance, has quite correctly said that what Canadians want is peace and prosperity, not war and austerity. So with that, let's bring that banner forward. We'll go down to where the police cars are, and we'll begin the march. Thank you very much.
Okay, how long have you been coming to peace festivals, peace marches?
Over 10 years, maybe even 15.
Why do you keep coming back?
Because it's an ongoing issue, and the situation isn't seeming to get much better. I recall when there was that protesting against going to Iraq, in 2003, and we knew this was the beginning of a nightmare. And even as the people are pulling out, it's just created an even worse mess than it was. There's better ways of doing business in the peace world. So I just keep hoping that this is one yearly annual venue that people of similar minds and hearts come together. So it's encouraging for me to connect up with old friends.
Thank you.
How many years have you been coming to these events, Garth?
You know, I've been coming to Peace Alliance events for about 10 years or so.
And what keeps you coming back?
I think it's just the great people that organize these events and come to them, and it's a feeling of solidarity and a feeling of being with people that have the same kind of ideas I do.
And what ideas are those?
Well, it's just the idea that we can make a better world by working together, and also just to raise a voice against prevailing attitudes that war is a solution to problems. So it's like there's another way of doing things, and events like this and the people that organize them and come to them are the first step towards making a better world.
To introduce the MC for the Peace Festival, Nadia Kidwai, and I will let her give her introduction of herself.
That was a great introduction, Glenn, thank you. My name is Nadia Kidwai. I am your intrepid, happy, enthusiastic MC for this afternoon. I am a journalist and the program manager for the Canadian Muslim Leadership Institute. I've always wanted to be an MC in the rain, so now's my chance. I'm a positive person, so I'm just gonna look at it like that. Well done, all of you who walked around. I was cheering for you in spirit in the dryness and warmth. Before we start, I just wanna say a big thank you and acknowledge our funders. So I'm going to go ahead and read them out. Assiniboine Credit Union, the Cambrian-Agassiz Kairos, National Association of Japanese Canadians, United Church of Canada, Conference of Manitoba in Northwestern Ontario, Unemployed Youth Africa, the Manitoba Government Employees Union, and Fernwood Publishing. So a big round of applause to our funders who believe in funding peace and prosperity and not war and austerity. Okay, so I would like to call upon our first act, Little Bird Singing, also known as Helena Kelly. She will now appear from the rain. Something's wrong with the sound, so we'll just fix that. We're competing with thunder here. This doesn't usually happen, but we shall be louder than the thunder. Helena's just coming, but again, I want to also acknowledge the participating organizations who are also supporting today's Peace Festival, Art City, Common Sense Storehouse, Council of Canadians, Winnipeg Chapter, Flaming Trolleys, great name, Independent Jewish Voices, Islam Alive, Islamic Social Services Association, Institute for International Women's Rights Manitoba, Justice for Omar Khadr, National Association of Japanese Canadians, Peace Alliance Winnipeg, Project Peacemakers, the Raging Grannies, Solidarity, yes, I hope to join the Raging Grannies one day when I'm a granny, a Solidarity Committee for Ethiopian Political Prisoners, the United Church of Canada, Conference of Manitoba in Northwestern Ontario, Winnipeg Social Forum, and obviously all our funders. Wanted to acknowledge them. Thank you so much for your support. And I'd now like to welcome Little Bird Singing. Thank you. Give it up for Little Bird Singing.
Good afternoon. My name is Little Bird Singing from the Eagle Clan. My English name is Helena, and I'm proud to stand here and represent peace for all. I am called to do the woman's warrior. And for me, it also represents in my heart, when I sing it, it represents peace. And I'm hoping that all of you here, brothers and sisters, and all of you in the world, that you will find peace today. If there's a one little thing in your heart that gives you joy, you will also find peace in your heart. Thank you. Join me during the last round. I will stop the drum, and for those of you who want to join me in the last round, you may. Thank you.
Miigwech to Little Bird Singing, and I don't know about you, but I thought it was kind of amazing whenever the thunder goes, whenever she was singing. That was pretty cool. Our next group is, or next act performance is Jay Stoller from Drummers United. Drummers United has been performing around Winnipeg for several years now. Those in the group belong to the advanced level drumming classes taught by Jay Stoller throughout the year. Members have been working hard, practicing, and are happy to share with you some West African rhythms played on the djembe drums. So, Drummers United, give it up for them.
Thank you.
raging grannies come up. The grannies and they're raging. Raging and aging. Okay, this is how you change the world, one raindrop at a time. Only the brave come out to an event like this, right? Give yourselves a hand, okay? Woo! Well, we call ourselves the Raging Grannies for Social Justice. We formed as the last province in Canada. The other provinces started about 27 years ago in Victoria, and they tried to get rid of a military sub in the harbor. That's the beginning of it. Now, we believe that we should go to rage and the red hats go to lunch. There's a difference between us and them. There are 72 gaggles across North America. And keep your eyes open. There's a movie coming out soon about the Raging Grannies on June 26th at Montreal at the Unconvention for Grannies. We have two grannies here going to that. So we're going to sing for you now. And it is going to be introduced. Okay.
So Pack Up Your Troubles was written in the First World War by George Powell, and we're going to sing our version of it, just updated a little bit. Here we go. Pack up your missiles and disarm them all and make no more. It is disarmament makes us gentle, not weapons of war. Of missiles, duly used to kill. So pack up your missiles and disarm them all. It just takes will. Oh, thank you guys for being out there in the rain. We need your help. If you can hear me, watch my hands. We sing sound off and you sing one, two. Sound off, you sing three, four. One, two, three, four, one, two. No war. I don't know, but I've been told recruiters getting way too bold. Hear closely what recruiters say. They will trick you anyway. We hear they fib, we hear they lie. They don't tell you, you must die. Sound off, one, two. Sound off, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two. No war! I don't know, but I've been told you take care of us when we're old. Pension clawbacks just ain't fair. Breaking promises that we're there. Sound off, one, two. Sound off, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two. No war! I don't know if you're aware. Soldier suicide in the air. Don't count on those benefits to leave you flat if you get sick. If you listen to their lies, you can kiss your ass goodbye. Sound off, one, two. Sound off, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two. No war!
I don't know. Do you want to stop there?
I think so.
Yeah.
Working on this ship, we may never sail on.
Ships don't sail, they sail one day.
Working on this ship, we may never sail on. Ain't I a woman? Ship's gonna sail, soon sail on May. Mother Jones said, no child labor. Ship's gonna sail, soon sail on May. Eugene Debs said, no more prison. Ship's gonna sail, soon sail on May. Joe Hill said, don't mourn, organize. Ship's gonna sail, soon sail on May. Working on the ship, we may never sail on. Martin Luther King said, I have a dream. Ship's gonna sail, soon sail one day. Malcolm X said, how is the people? Ship's gonna sail, soon sail one day. Working on a ship, we may never sail on. Ship's gonna sail, soon sail one day. Working on a ship, we may never sail on. We're gonna build it anyway. Dorothy Day said, swords into plowshares. Ship's gonna sail, soon sail one day. Judy Berry said, no compromise. Ship's gonna sail, soon sail one day. Bill Berrigan said, no more animals. Ship's gonna sail, soon sail one day. Utah Phillips said, sing through the hard times. Ship's gonna sail, soon sail one day. Working on a ship, we may never sail on.
I hope you all got a chance to speak a little bit to each other. Next time we do this, it's going to be sunny, okay? Yay! Thanks, guys. Just one quick note. Oh, who cares? We'll move on to the next act. I would like to introduce my new BFF, Ritallin from Toronto, who will now be doing some spoken words, a.k.a. Greg Frankson. He's a Toronto-based poet, art educator, and media personality. He is the resident poet on CBC Radio 1, Toronto's afternoon show, Here and Now. Ritallin is a 2012 National Slam champion who has been active in anti-discrimination and anti-poverty movements in his community. Woo! Ritallin, yeah!
Hi, everybody. How's it going? It's super wet out here. But I've got to tell you that it hasn't put any kind of a damper on the need to achieve and find peace and solidarity across the world. Would you not agree with me? Excellent. So I'm going to do a couple of poems, and I hope you enjoy it. I've been having a good time hanging out under various tents and getting a little feedy on the back. Oh. Hi. Okay, so I'm gonna wait for a little sound adjustment here. Maybe move it a little further back. Make sense? This is great. I get to be even further under the tent. I actually like this plan. This is a much better plan. Okay, so I live in Ontario. We just had an election yesterday, or the day before, sorry. And we didn't elect a conservative government, and I can't tell you how pleased I am that that did not happen. And the leader of the party resigned, which was also awesome, because he's really bad news. And so the first poem I'm going to do today is called Outrage, and it's in honor of Tim Hudak, the recently retired leader of the Ontario Progressive Conservatives. Outrageous! Let's build prisons to our ambitions and gallows for our hopes. Let's cut funding to strategic plans we make to uplift ourselves and our neighbors. In the name of progress, we should allow our governments to limit democracy, then exhale pollution like addicted chain smokers so they can more efficiently darken the sky. Hand the keys to the cops who lock kids in the shop to rough them up from bottom to top, and let them set up pig pens in the centers of our cities and our consciousness without debate or effective challenge. Let's hand over our social movements to prima donnas, the latte liberals who know the Latin language of liberty but only instigate increases in dissatisfaction of racialized peoples. Polling numbers for conservatives and their own bank balances tell me, where do you fall on that continuum between the powerfully active and the actively powerful? Take the time to realize that as we take the time to develop a more suitable response, time is taken away from doing the most critical work, and time is taking away from giving support to those in need, and time is ticking away, and what are we doing to turn back the hands of time, to reset them to where we were in our brightest of hours, and recast every minute of our lives to reflect those days as years turn into decades under a paradigm of the community's creation, where the weak from week to week can claim the supports they need for an eternity. Where is our outrage when the indigenous of this land place 5 centuries of misrepresentation on the feast table of our communal humanity, only to have it swept aside in favor of passing around white plates and weapons of mass consumption to those privileged enough to be served? Napkins used to wipe the corners of satisfied mouths are then crammed into famished maws too hungry for justice and proud of the products of their history to remain silent in the face of such tyranny. So as our prison towers reach the sky, built on bricks laid by neocon ideologues and held fast by mortar mixed by progressives who use wavering self-confidence and electoral timidity, it's become clear the longer we remain set in that cast, the harder it will get to cut ourselves out of such defeatist self-imposed constructs and break away from that discomforting mold. Ask me to bare my neck to the blade of injustice and accept social death through billions of cuts, and I shall respond that I do not condone nor accede to the systemic destruction of our communal hopes. So I lift my words in the hope my voice will blend with those who truly want the change they preach. And when that cacophonous rumble shouts down the Jericho walls built around this land's natural God-given prosperity, we must then crush those fallen bricks beneath the overwhelming weight of the needs of the many, too long suppressed by the wants of the precious few. But until that glorious climactic day, I ask, where is the outrage? Where on earth, where in Canada, is the bloody outrage? Thank you. That was just a little something from what I like to say when I do poems. The second piece is probably my best known poem. And I'm the child of Jamaican immigrants, first generation Canadian, who throughout my life, and even during my week and a half where I've been here in Winnipeg, having to deal with people treating me a certain way because of the way that I look. And so part of the process of finding peace is finding, means of commonality around issues of race and ethnicity. So this poem is one that begins with a question that every immigrant or child of immigrants like me hates to hear. Where are you from? No, let me ask that again. I said, where are you from? Because black folks are definitely not Johnny come lately. Our contributions are critical, central, and stately. When Champlain claimed New France for the Gaul with the crown, who did he have with him to guide him around but Matthew da Costa, who knew the lay of the land and the languages spoken we know he could understand? But how would he know them unless he got here before the man credited with breaking new ground in our lore? The sheer gall with which power tries to silence, suppress the pain and the triumphs of my people, I guess time is now I say something and make myself clear. My home is here. East York was the place where my life began, at Toronto East General Hospital, by the capable hands of a Polish-born doctor who had a daughter the same age. He and my Jamaican mom watched as both children were raised by people who came to Canada for hope and a chance that their kids would develop the means to advance and have impact and blaze a path curtained in snow in a land where my blackness at 20 below shivers shaking in shelters to go fight for my due. But now I plow ahead knowing what all of us knew. This nation was snatched from indigenous hands and built by their blood at oppression's commands. Disenfranchised, ignored, and whitewashed to submit to the dominant power of the French and the Brits all the way to today. And the rest benefit from the theft of a livelihood we won't admit provides the foundations for an immigrant preserve while original peoples live third world on reserves. Now take a walk around downtown Halifax. There's black people there, endured centuries of viciousness, violence, despair, oppressed by their neighbors and the governments of the day. Did you think that those memories would simply fade away? The loyalists, maroons, and Africville stains are notable due to overt glints of chains. Revisionist bigots tried to gloss over those crimes of humanity, held hostage by their odious designs. I remind all those people who think Canada's mosaic is anything but farcical, mythic, and prosaic, that if you scatter a mess and then claim that it's beauty, to refuse to clean it up is dereliction of duty. When that's followed by attempts to cover up mistakes, how can we boldly assert that we're better than the states? I declare, those who question my rights to this place based solely on the color of my skin and my race have been brainwashed to believe that our history is only white. And Laurier, King, and Trudeau held upright are the models our kids must be taught in our schools in the hope we adults are uncritical fools who revere that old leader who gave Smuts the idea to fleece black South Africans like Jason and Medea and build a golden oasis, an African sanctuary based on our racist Indian Act. We duped the unwary to believe King's xenophobia and Trudeau's false construction of a society that justly birthed racial hatred's destruction. That idea is so ingrained it's now treated as a fact that our nation is the world's promulgation of a pact that assures immigrant groups that their vices abroad can be stifled over here. Mm-mm. That perspective's a fraud. Black people here can tell you that racism's alive and encumbering restraint so that it's harder to thrive. So take heed and don't step up and glibly succumb to the urge to ask with arrogance. Hey, where are you from? I'm born of this land and it's here that I remain. And the depths of my roots allow me to ascertain without doubt that this land of water, rocks, trees, and ice is exactly where I belong. My forebears paid the price so I can stand here and state with no shame and no fear, my home is here. And so I've been in Winnipeg since last week because I came for the Winnipeg Spoken Word Festival, and Margaret came and saw me perform at that festival, and she was like, you need to come and share this piece that I'm going to share with you and end with, a message of peace, of hope, of understanding, of building towards a better future for ourselves and for the generations to come. This piece samples a song by the late, great Sam Cooke. And it is a poem about social justice, about honor, and about peace. And I hope you enjoy it. And thank you guys very much for inviting me to be here today. Despite the rain, it's amazing. You know, it's like they say, no rain, no gain, right? All right, so this piece goes like this. Cupid, draw back your bow and let your arrow go straight to my lover's heart for me. Ignorance is truly bliss amongst the rich about the poor, sipping on some cafe lattes, while the people in Darfur scream to catch the world's attention instead of bullets to the brain. The people of Kashmir, Afghanistan, and Iraq can feel their pain. Paramilitaries and government troops overtly fanning out to intimidate the citizens who went submissive, granting clout to whichever faction controls the drug trade, or the opium, oil, or blow. Hack and shoot any dissenters hot to bring the warlords low. Whether we're talking about child soldiers or those trapped in maquiladoras, we're just thankful for the coffee, diamonds, and goods they're making for us. While the people we empower pass legislation we can parse, turning crucial UN resolutions into a bloody farce. So go ahead and call us liberal bleeding hearts, but our hands will never be smeared like them Macbeth stained parks. It's at the juncture where love ends and hate starts, where we make our stand for peace in our trenches and ramparts. I'll get you out for peace-focused demonstrations across our principalities, territories, and nations. Load up your quiver for hatred's elimination. Time for some action, needing your participation. It may sound militant, but I'm fighting for peace. So pay attention to this poetry, my verbal release. And if you think about it, there ain't no other way to go than to make like Sam Cooke and draw back your bow. Cupid, please hear my cry and let your arrow fly straight through my lover's heart for me. People in the Balkans trying to assert their sovereignty when their opponents came to storm the American embassy. Independence for Kosovo was voted democratically, but the Serbians weren't hearing it. It simply could not be. Did anybody want more war by the Adriatic Sea or a reprise of the cleansings based on white ethnicity? Because it's not just black people committing mass atrocity that's based on power and vengeance and war philosophy. So don't tell me that it's Africa that's the problem across the board when it is Israel building walls like the Germans have abhorred since 89. When it crumbled and East Berliners wept and danced, did they dream of a repeat of their oppressive circumstance? Nah, some of them died so they could give freedom a chance, reignite shattered lives and hope their lessons would advance the global view on what divides us so we could hope for better things. But our amnesia and our apathy, just look at what that brings. I'll get you out for peace-focused demonstrations across our principalities, territories, and nations. Load up your quiver for hatred's elimination. Time for some action, needing your participation. It may sound militant, but I'm fighting for peace. So pay attention to this poetry, my verbal release. And if you think about it, there ain't no other way to go than to make like Sam Cooke and draw back your bow. So, Cupid, draw back your bow and let peace arrows flow straight through warmongers' hearts for me and everybody like me. Cupid, please hear my cry and let those arrows fly straight through those hate-filled hearts for all of we. Thank you guys very much. Thank you so much.
So I'm pretty sure Ritalin made the rain stop. Thanks for that. Amazing. I just wanted to mention a couple of the things about him. He is the Poet Laureate for the International Initiative for Mental Health Leadership. He published Cerebral Stimulation in 2006 and has collaborated with notable DJs, MCs like me now, poets and musicians. He seeks to inform, entertain, and inspire through socially conscious messages in his poetry, and I think we all witnessed that just now. Our next act is Tamara Hajsky. So Tamara, if you could come up. I just want to read something that she had written herself. Dance and song is my passion, and after years of experiencing many forms of movement, yoga, belly dancing, Latin dancing, and aerobics, I found Nia and my life transformed. My wish is that all beings connect with their joy, their inner light, and share it with the world. Tamara Hajsky, everyone.
Thank you. Awesome. Hi, everyone. I think I can't see everyone. All right. It's an honor for me to be up here and share a little bit of something that I do and how I share my light with the world. So my invitation here is, I'm not so much of a, well, although I can be, showgirl, but I really like to bring people in and participate, and everyone kind of just do what you want to do with an invitation to move a certain way or raise your voices a certain way. So my what I wanted to do today was a little bit of movement, and I think we're just gonna move to the silence and the sound of the rain, and not necessarily, and maybe the sound of the goat, not necessarily the music. And then maybe we'll sing a little song at the end, a little sort of call and response cue time. So, wherever you're standing, I just want you to start to sense your body and start to connect with your feet, the feet that are always walking on this planet. Knowing that each step, each stance, each movement of our feet can give a little more vibration down into the earth of our love and our peace that starts here inside of our body. So sensing your feet and then sensing your lower legs. Really notice how your lower legs connect your feet from the earth up into your knees. And then since your thighs, you got really long thigh bones, and they're there whether you know it or not. Everybody's got these two legs, they're beautiful. And then up into your hip joints. Beginning to flow energy, life force energy, which you know exists by seeing how things grow. Bringing it up the legs, and up into the pelvis. And the pelvis is this beautiful container. You have beautiful organs inside that contain things like food and water, like our bladder, and sexual energy. So just breathing up energy, and we're gonna just cultivate some peace today. Peace for the Peace Fest and prosperity, knowing that we are the sources of our abundance. and breathing further up into our chest. The ribs are beautiful bones protecting our heart and lungs. Again, beating and breathing involuntarily, whether you're aware of it or not. And breathing further up, letting that peaceful energy charge up your whole brain and spinal cord. And the arms, letting the arms fill with peaceful energy. A couple nice deep breaths in. Another nice deep breath in and start to sense your shoulders. And just moving your shoulders up and down in circles around. And then check into your elbows. I want to see some elbows moving. You guys have elbows? Show me your elbows. And just how they open and close. They just want to open and close and just letting them. And while we move energy today in our bodies, just right here, it can have an intention of moving peace, right? Because it's a force. And then your hands. And this is really easy, everyone. You got two hands. Just start to open and close your hands, pumping energy. So imagine pumping, because this space, imagine it's like palpable, and you can actually squeeze something out of this life force energy. You can see electric lightning when it comes down through the water. And then from pumping, do we have anyone pumping hands? And then flick the energy away because there's sometimes excess. Yeah. And then shaking it out the arms. Shake out the arms. And then with our ankles, we're just going to wake up their ankles by just coming up onto the balls of our feet and dropping back down. Just open up the ankles. You can do it. No one's going to judge you unless you're judging yourself. Yeah. So I do this every day in the shower. I wake up my ankles. Good time to, no one's watching. Wake up ankles and wrists. Really important. We forget that we need to actually keep these joints moving. So now that we're a little bit more open, let's just reach our arms above the head so we can sing and open our voices. And really reach those arms out as you drop them down, either in front or on the side, wherever space you have.
All right.
So I do some chanting with Kristen Andrews every Monday at Dragon Arts Collective. We have a little chanting circle. And one of the songs that we always open with is called One by One, written by Michael Stillwater. So I'll just sing. There's three sentences, I guess, in three parts, really short. I'll sing one. You sing it back to me, I'll sing the second, you sing it back to me, I'll sing the third, you sing it back to me. All right.
You like tea? Mm-hmm. You get that?
One by one, everyone comes to remember. One by one, everyone comes to remember. That's your part. We're healing the world. We're healing the world. One heart at a time. One heart at a time. One by one, everyone comes to remember.
One by one, everyone comes to remember.
We're healing the world.
We're healing the world.
One heart at a time. Couple more times together. One by one, everyone comes to remember.
One
by
one, everyone.
One heart at a time. Invitation to really feel it.
One by one, everyone comes to remember. We're here.
And that's to remember the quote from Rumi: yesterday I was clever and I thought I'd change the world, but today I'm wise and I thought I'd change myself. Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you so much for coming and staying and listening and supporting. I'd like to ask Glenn to come up now and say a few words. I've had a great time emceeing and meeting you guys, and until next time. Thank you.
Thank you, Nadia, for excellent emceeing under difficult conditions. And thank you, everybody, for persevering under difficult conditions, our performers, all of those who came and participated in the festival. It shows that we can do it under any circumstances, not only just good weather, but inclement weather like we had today. So thank you very much. Before we close, I'd just like to say, if you're interested in participating in the organizing for next year's Walk for Peace or the Peace Festival, please leave your name with one of us, myself, Margaret Glavina, Karen, anybody who you know as being one of the organizers around or Mary. So please do so, because part of the success of this is that we have you in the community helping out with this. So again, thank you for making the 33rd Walk for Peace a tremendous success under difficult conditions, and the 4th annual Peace Festival an equal success. It was terrific entertainment and it was terrific food. So thank you very much, and that concludes today. We'll see you next year.